everybody, and welcome again to the lecture series of linear algebra. So, in this session, we are going to talk about indexing and slicing as far as NumPy arrays are concerned, okay? So, first of all, we have to import NumPy as np. Then, we are creating an array function and we just have to define the list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, for example. So, we can use the so-called indices. This is exactly what we have been talking about when dealing with Python's built-in list data structure, yeah? Or whenever we are manipulating strings. So, we can access the A's based on the indices, yeah? If we want to get the first number of A, we just have to define index 0. And observe that it is going to return with the first item. The second item has index 1. And what's crucial to show that we can also use negative indices here, okay? So, negative indices represent indices starting from the last item. Therefore, minus 1 means that the last item, now if we run the application, then 10, yeah? Therefore, the last item of the array is going to be returned here, right? Again, minus 2 means that second from the last one. So, basically, the second item starting with the last one, and this is the first item, and this is the second item, yeah? So, 9 is going to be a return here. Okay, so what's crucial that we can use slicing with the colon operator. By that, I mean that we can get a subarray based on indices. For example, if we want to get the item starting with index 0 up to, say, index 4, then what's going to be the result? Well, Python here is going to return with the subarray starting with the first item, okay? So, observe that index 0 up to index 4 is exclusive. That is, index 4 is not going to be included, okay? Index 0, index 1, index 2, index 3 and index forward. So, as you can see, index 4 is the value 5, right? But 5 is not present in the result. So, the index 4 is not going to be included in the result, correct? Now, what if we would like to start with 2 up to say 7, for example? Well, we can do it without any issue, and Python is going to return with this subarray. And what's crucial that the first index is going to be included in the result here, okay? But observe that the second index, that is the end of the interval, is not going to be included here, right? Now, if we want to start with the first item, we can use index 0. But if we do not specify an index at all, then by default, Python will start with the first item. Therefore, if we start with 0, we can easily omit 0 because this is the default value. Okay. Similarly, for the last index, if we want to use the last index, then basically we don't have to define it because the default value is the last index. Okay. Now, if we use the colon operator without defining the starting index and the ending index, that is the end of the index, then all the items are going to be returned. Okay, since the default value is 0, so the start of the array and the last index, so the end of the array. Yeah, and of course we can also define the so-called increment, that is the step size. Say we start with the index 0 up to index 7 with step size 1. And what does it mean is that every single item between the two indices, of course we can define 2 as a step size. And what does that mean? That we would like to consider the items from index 0 up to index 6 because 7 is inclusive here. So these are the values we are going to consider with step size 2. Yeah. So what does it mean that we consider 1, then we skip a given item, then 3, then skip the next item, then 5, and then skip the next item, and then 7 finally. So this is how we can change the step size without any issue. Okay, and it is going to work just fine. Yeah. So if that step size is greater than 0, so it is a positive value. It means that from left to right. On the other hand, if the step size is negative, it means that from right to left. Okay, so if we define index 7 up to index 1, because now we are considering the array from right to left and the step size is minus 1 here, it means that we are going from right to left. In this case, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, and 3. Yeah. So as you can see, these items are going to be included, but in reverse order, because we have used negative values. Yeah. Of course, the step size can be 2 as well. And in this case, 8, 6, and 4. So 8 is going to be included. Then we will skip given number. Then 6 is going to be included and we skip the next value. So if we use negative step size, it means that we consider the values from right to left. Okay. And if we use positive values, it means that we are considering the items from left to right. Okay. Of course, we have to make sure that if the step size is smaller than 0, so it has a negative value, then we have to make sure that the start index is greater than the end index, which means that we consider the items from right to left. And if the step size is greater than 0, then we have to make sure that the first index is smaller than the end index. Okay, otherwise the result is going to be an empty list, which means that something is wrong here, right? Of course, we have to make sure that we use something like this. Okay, and in this case it is going to work just fine. See, Now, if we do not specify the first index, then it is going to be 0, right? And if we do not specify the last index, then it is going to be the end of the list, yeah? If we specify minus 1, what does it mean? Well, that is from right to left. Now, if we run the application like this, as you can see, this is exactly what we have been talking about the strings. That this is how we can reverse the NumPy array, yeah? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 is the original array. And with the help of colon, colon, minus 1, the result will be 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So, this is how we can use indices with the help of a single index. We can get a given value present in the array. Now, if we use negative indices, it means that we start with the last item. We can use slicing with a single colon or double colon operator if we want to define the step size as well. And this is how we can reverse that given one-dimensional array. Of course, it remains same if we have a multi-dimensional array, okay? For example, something like this. We have a second array, let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 10. Then we want to get the index 1. Well, what does it mean? That we are going to consider that second subarray. And after that, we would like to define the index of the item. We would like to get, for example, 2 is going to represent 0, 1, 2. So, this value. So, if we use something like this and rerun the application, of course, there are going to be an error because, can you tell? Yes, we have to define the multidimensional array like this. Remember, in our last session, we have discussed this. And this is how we can get the value from the second subarray, yeah? As far as index 2 is concerned, indices starts with 0, index 0, index 1, index 2. So, this is why the result will be 3 here, okay?